When my cousin went to court Wednesday, which was the 17th, my cousin went to the court. The magistrate took back my cousin's bail. And when they took back the bail now, he ended up in a depression under the frustration that he was going through and drank poison, a poison substance. Right? Right now, my cousin in the hospital, I don't know if he will make it.
TV6 News spoke with Miss Isis Reid outside the Scarborough General Hospital about the unsanitary conditions at the halfway home.
He said the facilities that the court send the prisoners and them, nobody here is happy. The place is dirty. Besides the place dirty, they have rules and regulations. TV's off. TV's off at 10. Rats all over. Dirtiness, the couch. He tried to clean. So when he tried to clean now, he has my asthma.
Miss Reid told the TV6 News she has to pay monthly installments for the ankle bracelet her relative wears. If not, she is called in by police.
Have to pay monies every month for the monitor.
For the monitor on his foot. $350. My cousin not working nowhere. I see one that paying for the monitor on his foot. Right? I just sell little clothes, little fried chicken, this, try to make a little dollar when the day come, because I'm not working nowhere neither. I have a 2-year-old son to see about.
TV6 News contacted the manager of the franchise, Layman Halfway Home, Warren Tidd. Mr. Tidd said he has had issues with some former prisoners who refuse to adhere to the rules and regulations at the home. The home is one where former prisoners can seek shelter if they have no place to go.
You said that he has a notorious behavior.
Yes, a very much notorious behavior. Let's imagine you getting up 11 and 12 o'clock in the night and he has the door open and he sit down in the pot smoking weed. I thought twice with my eyes, I said, why are you doing that? I said, why are you operating that kind of way? I said, the first time, I said, look at the book, you see the book, 100 and something people stay here and we never get that behavior.
Mr. Tidd then admitted to the unsanitary conditions at the home. But not only that, he is owing on rent and is in arrears on payments for electricity and water bills. Mr. Tidd said attempts to apply for a subvention from the THA have all failed, and as a result, he cannot fulfill all of his financial obligations.
Mr. Tidd, we have also received reports from some relatives that the environment is in an unsanitary condition.
Okay. Yes, that is true. I would not deny that because of the fact that we, since the franchise is up and running and doing this service here in the Bay, we have not never yet collect a subvention from nowhere. Central government, nowhere. We
have never. You applied? Have you tried?
We have applied. The THA promised that they would have been working on one. They come for the information, they gather the information, all the information is there, and for some reason or the other, I don't know, I'm not getting no wording on that, and that's the reason why if I don't come out here and sell the coconuts, as you see, I sell the coconuts and vegetables, I would not be able to pay a light bill, I would not be able to pay a water bill, I would not be able to buy smellopine, I would not be able to buy soap.
Elizabeth Williams, TV6 News.